Good afternoon, everyone, and good afternoon, the juries. Today my presentation is on DNA identification and forensic odontology. Introduction. Teeth are the most hardest and the sturdy tissues in the human body. Teeth has relatively, just a second, ma'am. Yes. Teeth have relatively high degrees of physical and chemical resistance. They are the excellent source of genomic and mitochondrial DNA to human identification process, which is protected by epithelial, connective, muscular, and bony tissues in the case of incineration. Additionally, the dental pulp cells are protected by enamel, dentine, and cementum hard dental tissues. When traditional methods become impossible, in such cases, DNA identification plays a major role. DNA profiling or DNA fingerprinting has become a long way from conventional fingerprints. The method, this review provides the overview of published studies on the recent evolution in the isolation of DNA and the ways of different DNA profiling. The objectives of DNA profiling includes identification of criminals, identification of victims, diagnosis of inherited disorders and paternity disputes. The discussion. DNA profiling is also called as DNA typing, DNA testing, or DNA fingerprinting. It is a technique used by forensic scientists to distinguish between the individuals of same species using the samples of same species. It is a forensic technique in criminal investigations, comparing criminal suspects' profiles to DNA evidence so as to assess like likelihood of their involvement in the crime. It is also used in the parentage testing to establish immigration eligibility and genealogical and medical research. The process of DNA profiling was invented by Alec John Jeffries. DNA profiling reveals the genetic makeup of a person. So dental pulp provide an excellent source of DNA as they remain virtually unaffected by the environmental assaults. Proper DNA isolation and quantification are needed to perform a successful analysis. When the amount of evidence left at the crime site is very small, it is considered to be a trace evidence. So the use of polymerase chain reaction technique, we can generate multiple identical copies from trace amount of original DNA evidence. This enables forensic scientists to make billions of DNA copies from small amount of DNA in just few hours. And the DNA produced with PCR can be analyzed using DNA fingerprinting techniques. Now, just briefing about steps of DNA profiling. The first is extraction. Then comes the restriction fragments with certain restriction enzymes. Then comes the amplification with using the PCR technique. Then comes the electrophoresis, transfer, probing, and then DNA fingerprinting. Now, starting with few of the DNA fingerprinting techniques. The first coming to restriction fragment length polymerization. In order to study the structure of DNA, the molecules are broken up into smaller fragments by enzymes called restriction enzymes. The restriction enzymes do not break up the DNA molecule randomly, but it cuts it in the particular sites, producing fragments which are easier to analyze based on their length. Polymorphism means many types or many forms, and this method requires larger quantities of DNA and requires very much long waiting time to obtain the results. The second test is short tandem repeat test. This is the most commonly used test, and the STR technology is used to evaluate specific regions or loci within the nuclear DNA. Variability of STR regions can be used to distinguish one DNA profile from another. The word short is used because it is usually used for 1 to 4 nucleotides in length. Tandem means they occur one after the other, and repeat means how many number of repeats are seen in the DNA sequence. It is frequently and routinely used marker in forensics, and STRs have a high power of individual discernment because of the high standards of polymorphic informative content. It also helps in identifying victims of mass calamities from even old remains. The third is mitochondrial DNA analysis with the help of mitochondrial DNA. Sometimes the sample can be old and will no longer have nuclear material in the cell, which poses a problem for other types of DNA analysis. So with the help of mitochondrial DNA analysis, however, mitochondrial DNA can be removed and thus have an important ramifications for cases that were not solved over many years. It is only used which are inherited from the mother. Advantages, it is more sensitive and it degrades very slower compared to nuclear DNA. and can be used in the cases where nuclear DNA cannot, that is hair without root, skeletal remains. And disadvantages are all the people of same maternal line are very much difficult to distinguish, and it requires more time, and also it is time and it's time consuming, and it is very costly. The other test is analysis of Y chromosome. It involves the targeting of polymorphism regions of Y chromosome using primers. As Y chromosome is passed to the son from his father, analysis of markers on the chromosome helps in sketching relationship among the males. The other test is single nucleotide polymorphism. This is a very emerging as a new marker of the interest to forensic community because of their abundance in the human genome and their low mutation rate, the opportunity they present of analyzing smaller fragments of deoxyribonucleic acid than with short tandem repeats. It is important in degraded DNA samples. The other test is DNA methylation. It's a biological process by which methyl groups are added to a DNA molecule. The methylation can change the activity of DNA segment without changing the sequence. And when located in the gene promoter, the DNA methylation typically acts to repress gene transcription. In mammals, DNA methylation is essential for normal development and is associated with number of key processes, including genomic imprinting, X chromosome inactivation, repression of transposable elements, aging, and carcinogenesis. DNA methylation is emerging as an attractive marker, providing investigative leads to solve crimes in forensic genetics. And the identification of body fluids that utilizes tissue-specific DNA methylation can contribute to solving crimes by predicting activity related to evidence material. It is also used for age estimation in forensic science and forensic odontology. Conclusion: the recent advances in DNA profiling have made DNA evidence to be more widely accepted in courts. When antemortem data are unavailable, DNA profiling becomes the sole and the reliable method for identification. The dentin and the pulp are the rich sources of DNA in the tooth. Dentin and cementum are also very much rich in the mitochondrial DNA. Sometimes a preserved unerupted third molar enables the DNA extraction from the dental pulp, and which is very useful. In addition to human identification, another subject of study of forensic dentistry related to molecular biology is the analysis of bite mark evidence. In cases of physical assault, such as sexual abuses, murders, and child abuse, bite marks are frequently found on the skin. These are my references. Thank you.